Oh my!
I can't believe Thomas would do such a thing! He's one of my best friends!
He was obviously jealous. Thomas is a good engine. Something must be terribly wrong for him to act this way. Where is he gone? The other engines don't want me around. They wish I wasn't here at all. Thomas isn't a bad engine. He's a sad engine. We should give him space for now. Thomas is nowhere to be found.
He hasn't arrived, and I couldn't find him in any of the sheds here.
Oh dear, we should tell the Fat Controller. Bust my buffers! There's no way I make it out of here alive! Oof. Whoa! Whew! A track! But how am I going to get onto it? I suppose it's what I deserve for what I've done. I'll blow my whistle one last time. It's Stanley! Thomas! Stanley, I'm sorry that I was horrible to you. I was wrong. And I was silly to be cross that you were in charge. Thomas, we will be friends, and I'll have you back on that track in no time. I can do it! Hooray! Thank you, Stanley. You saved me. Now let's go home. Stanley was puffing happily along the line. Sir Topham Hatt had decided to let him stay on the island after James had an accident. Stanley was helping with the extra goods work, taking materials to Great Walcherton. Hello everyone! Oh, Stanley, how are you this fine afternoon? Quite well, Henry. What are you doing here? The Fat Controller is trying out a new passenger train for the summer, and I get to pull it. Excellent. I'm helping with James's work while he's being repaired.
Oh dear, yes. That was a horrible accident he had. Worse than mine, it looked.
Stanley shunted his trucks into the siding next to the main line. Henry was almost ready to leave. On board his train was the railway inspector. He had come following the crash on Edward's line.
Make way, please!
The shunter was struggling with the coupling, but Henry was impatient. Goodbye, Henry! Henry steamed out of the station. Stanley changed tracks and puffed alongside Thomas. Rocky was helping move old interior parts from the station. Good day, Thomas. And what excuse have you to be off your branch line this time? Rosie wanted to practice passengers again, so the fat controller let us switch. I mean, made us. I can't stand to leave Annie and Clarabelle. We all heard you the first time, Thomas. Anyhow, I'm really happy you get to stay on the island, Stanley. We need more good engines like you. I'm happy too, Thomas. I would like to get away from odd jobs all the time, though. Maybe I'll find a branch line for myself. Ha ha. Uphill, Henry was working hard. There was a tricky section of track that made Stanley slip before. And this time, it got Henry.
Move!
But the coaches had other ideas.
Oh no!
Just then, Stanley heard an emergency whistle.
Oh no, not again!
Cinders and ashes! Stanley ran backwards to catch the coaches. Steady, boy. Almost. Got him! Well done, Stanley. The passengers cheered. The inspector was very grateful. Right place at the right time, Stanley. You saved us all. I'm going to report this to Sir Topham Hatt. Yes, sir. Thank you. Henry was recoupled properly, and they set off again in silence. Sir Topham Hatt soon heard the news. He went to visit Stanley.
You did well today, Stanley. Your heroic saved many passengers, and I'm proud of you.
I'm happy to be useful, sir.
Well then, how would you like to pull the Great Waterton Special? It only runs during the summer months. But it would give you a regular job, which I know you've been wanting.
Oh, yes, sir. I'd love to have my own train.
Then it's settled. Henry is going to have his couplings inspected before he's allowed to return to work. I have to settle some other items as well.
Hello, sir. Butch! You mustn't sneak up on me like that.
My apologies, sir.
I see you brought my car. Do take care with it.
Yeah, about that. It's not doing so well. You might want to look at getting a new one.
Oh.
Sir Topham Hatt returned to his office. The telephone rang.
Hello?
Your new tank engine came in handy. I guess you needed him to make up for all the unsafe ones.
I appreciate your margin for error. This isn't a good look, but I want to support your efforts, Sir Topham. I'm going to help you protect steam. You'll need to meet me in the middle at some points. It sounds like you already have plans in motion.
Oh, believe me, I do.
Stanley loves his new train. He still has a lot of scattered jobs, but it's nice to have one that's his.
Stanley is happy on the island of Sodor, which may just be the most important thing for him.
Freddy was an old narrow-gauge engine who worked with Sir Handel and Peter Sam long ago on their old railway. He was reunited some years back with his friends on Scarlowe's line. Freddy loved being the most daring engine on the railway, even now. One day, he and Sir Handel were musing in the yard. Remember when we used to race our trains from the old mine?
Yes, I remember winning quite often.
That's not what I recall.
I remember. You two were stupid. I never approved of your racing.
You were an old fusspot, Duke.
Well, it kept you alive.
Peter Sam chimed in.
Do you remember that yellow engine we used to work with?
You mean Roy? Like daylight I do.
Roy, huh. I hated him too. Who would be painted such an outrageous color?
You had a race against him once, didn't you? Do tell.
Yes, we're very interested.
Well, all right then.
And this is the story that Freddy told. Back long ago, before the railway was in danger of closing, Freddy worked with Sir Handel and Peter Sam, who were named Falcon and Steward at the time. They also worked with Old Duke and an engine named Roy. Roy was spry for his age and competitive.
Beat you again, Freddy. You should really pick it up before you get scrapped.
No fear. I'm the fastest engine in the hills.
You make a bold claim. We shall have to settle this.
The next day, the manager arrived.
There's a large rock order. You two will collect the slate together. Take the trains down to the yard and be efficient.
This'll be fun.
Indeed. Freddy and Roy were each determined to be quicker than the other. Speed was efficiency, after all. They had collected their trains of stone.
All right, Roy. First engine down the mountain wins. Hope you can handle the steep slopes.
No fear. I've chuffered down these hills longer than you.
Well then, let's go!
Freddy and Roy raced down the hill with their heavy trains. They wheeshed and rocked around bends. Freddy wouldn't give up, and Roy wouldn't either.
Buffer to buffer. I'll soon put an end to this.
Oh, will you?
Then there was trouble. Roy hit a sharp bend. The train was too strong. Roy tumbled down the side of the mountain.
Flatten my funnel!
Freddy raced into the goods yard.
We need a search party. Roy has tumbled off the rails.
The manager assembled a team, and Freddy puffed up the hill to the place where Roy's train had derailed. The men looked around.
If he's not close to the rails, the search is no good. We don't have the equipment to move him down a country lane.
He's nowhere in sight.
Then Freddy had an idea.
There's a really old line further down. Roy may have crossed its path.
It's a long shot and risky, but we'll try it.
The old line had not been maintained for years. The ballast was worn and the rails were weak, but Freddy puffed on. At last,
Freddy!
By the craggy track, you're one lucky engine, Roy.
I know. I'm so glad you found me.
Freddy and the men worked hard. At long last, they were able to heave Roy onto the old track. And Freddy pulled them gently to safety. At the yard, Freddy spoke.
Well, Roy, I think at least you may have made it down the mountain faster than I did.
Ha! I suppose.
But coming after me was brave. You really are fearless, Freddy.
And after that, everyone started calling me Fearless Freddy. Some thought Fearless was my actual name. How did I never hear about this?
You were probably too busy with Sir Handel and me.
Most likely so, impudent scalawags.
What happened to Roy?
Oh, he worked for a few more years, but he was sold along with the rest of us. I don't know where he got off to.
Well, that's a nice story, but it's nothing compared to getting lost for years and having your shed overgrown.
No, Duke, you old salt.
All right, everyone back to work.
Duke is an old engine who mentored Sir Handel and Peter Sam when they were young. He was lost for years, and then one day, explorers found Duke asleep in an old shed. Now he helps with the summer tourist trains, but rests a lot because of his age. One day, his driver had news. We are to help pull some slate trucks today. We'll be working with Rusty the little diesel. Ah, trucks. It's been ages. No worry, I can still keep them in order. No doubt you can. And off they went. Soon they arrived at the slate quarry. Nice of you to join us. Who's this? Rusty, you've met before. I don't remember it. Mustn't have happened. Get yourself checked, driver. Anyhow, Mr. Rusty, why don't you show us the work? Right on, this way. They went to the yard where lots of cars were needed to be marshaled. Ah, it's been too long. Your buffers look like they've run off. Ha! In my day, engines were tough. We powered through without all the extra frills. They're more for safety. Duke wasted no time. Rusty gave him credit for the effort. The only thing that bothered him were some of Duke's questions. So you're a drizzle engine? No. A diesel engine? Diesel engine, Duke. Diesel, like the fuel. Diesel goes in trucks. Where do you put your coal? I'll say you're a worthy shunter, Rusty, for someone who barely puffs so much as a cloud of smoke. Imagine what you could do with more of a fire. Oh, the possibilities. Finally, it was time for them to leave. Rusty and Duke were going to bring the slate back to the junction. I'll lead. You must learn the line, young Rusty. Rusty was trying to exercise patience. Duke puffed and chuffed up the line of his heavy train. Rusty trundled behind. No games on this train. You be misinformed, trucks. I have to say I like his style. Yes, no nonsense around his grace. There ahead was the last big hill. Duke found it hard to keep puffing. Oh, I won't be beat. Come along, come along. The train was very heavy, especially for old Duke. He heaved with all his strength. Rusty looked on and saw the old engine's determination. It would be a shame if he had to call for a back engine. It would. Luckily, there's a gust of wind on the way. Ha, wonderful. Rusty nudged Duke's train from the rear, but he did it gently enough so that Duke couldn't tell. Ha ha, I've won! You can't win, trucks. Rusty grinned to himself. Later, Rusty and Duke were in the yard. What a fine trip. Did your train give you any hassle? A little bit, but I saw how you charged on. It helped me manage just fine. I'm glad I still have it in me. People treat you different with age. Gotta show them I'm no fragile pile of iron. For sure. I learned a lot today. Thanks for helping. Anytime. Oh, and Rusty. Thanks for the push. It's all right. I know I'm no rookie anymore, but we'll never speak of this again. Deal, then. Good. Next, we should see about getting you a proper funnel. Ha, it would be quite stylish. Young engines are always concerned about looks. For everything else, Duke, you're never boring.
It was a moonlit night on the island of Sodor. Mighty Mech was getting ready to take his last train down the mountain. Mighty Mech is a unique engine with two sides. One is called Mighty, and the other is called Mech. Mighty was taking the lead, as he always did.
So does this mean I get to lead on the slate run tomorrow?
Only if I'm unable to jam the turntable before then.
You manipulative, conniving...
Mighty Mech set off into the night. Even with his lantern, Mighty found it hard to see in the dark. He was still trying to learn the windy rails down.
Mighty, do you know where we're going?
Of course I do. My sense of direction has never steered us wrong.
Not entirely true.
Only when you refuse to cooperate, Mech.
You're not supposed to hear me!
Mighty Mech was so busy arguing, he didn't notice they were being routed off to a different track.
Mech, does this forest look familiar to you?
I don't know. I can't see much from here.
But it sure is dark. And foggy.
Oh, look! There's a tunnel up ahead.
The tunnel was long and dark. Mighty could hardly see.
This is definitely not the way we came.
Mighty Mech chuffed out the other side of the tunnel and came to a stop. Fog was everywhere.
I'm not sure, but it appears that we're on a mountainside. This isn't our route.
I think we're lost, but we're so far from the switches.
Best to go on, then. Mighty Mech came to an old mine in the woods. There seemed to be no way to go.
I can't see a thing! We're so far from home! Oh, I wish there were someone to help us!
Then, a light flashed ahead.
Follow me. I'll show you the way.
All right. Mighty Mech followed the voice. The fog was very thick. All he could see was the shape of an engine and his lamp. It was very bright and shone in the mist. The engine led them back to the main line.
This is where you need to go.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. We couldn't have made it without your...
Mighty, what's wrong?
Where did he go?
What?
He's gone.
That engine who helped us here.
That's ridiculous.
But there was no sign of the engine with a bright lamp. Mighty Mech finally finished their journey. It was very late. When they returned to the sheds, everyone else was asleep.
Mighty, so are we going to tell them about the engine?
I think it's better if we keep this to ourselves for now. The others will think we're off our bearings, especially Duke.
For once, I'd agree.
Mighty Mech still has no idea what or who they came across that night. But they do know they would not have made it home without a lamp so bright to guide them.
Thank you.
Sir Handel is a pompous little tank engine who works on Scarlowe's line. He's always ready to prove himself, and tends to get defensive when other engines tease him. One day, Sir Handel puffed into the wharf with his goods train. A new crane was there who he hadn't seen before.
Hey, who are you?
I'm Colin. Who are you?
I'm Sir Handel. I'm the strongest engine around here.
Is that so?
Certainly. Why do you think I'm called Sir Handel? Now, please unload my trucks.
All right.
Reneas was helping shunt the next train together.
Hello, Cullen. I see you've met Sir Handel.
Yes, indeed. Quite a character he is.
Oh, way to put it lightly.
Sir Handel says he's the strongest engine around.
Does he now? I wonder if we should test that.
Reneas puffed over to Sir Handel.
What's up, Lazy Wheels?
How rude. I'm a busy engine. I need my rest.
Of course. Pulling three little trucks around must be exhausting.
What?
Do you know what the record for the longest goods train from here to the junction is?
No. What is it?
10 trucks.
That's it?
That's the number.
I can beat that easily.
Oh, really?
Of course. They don't call me Sir for nothing.
Sir Handel shunted his trucks over to the wharf.
Back so soon? I thought this train was for Reneas. I have to show Reneas what a real engine can do. I'll need all the cargo you have.
If you say so.
I do.
Sir Handel went and found more trucks and added them to his train.
I'll show Reneas. I'll show everyone.
Not too bad, Sir Handel. But this won't do for the record. Are you sure you'll be able to call yourself Sir with only 7 wagons?
Easy now, I wasn't even finished adding trucks.
Sir Handel fetched another lot, and Colin loaded it with crates. But that wasn't enough. The little engine soon had a long line of 12 trucks.
There. That ought to do it.
Mighty, do you want to see something funny? Sir Handel is about to prove how strong he isn't.
All right, Colin. Watch and learn. They don't call me Sir for...
I know.
Sir Handel struggled and struggled. His wheels slipped.
Come on!
Oh dear, what's wrong, Sir Handel? This should be easy for you.
Ugh! Impossible! How can I not pull this train?
I wonder if I just...
Hurrah! I've done it!
Of course you did, Sir Handel. Of course. Later that evening, Sir Handel was bragging to the other engines.
And that's how I broke the record for longest train from the wharf. It was an amazing journey.
Ugh, this really backfired. I'm sorry you have to listen to him even more now, Peter Sam.
Not to worry, Reneas. Old Duncan and I have prepared a little surprise for our friend.
Aye, Sir Handel. That be a mighty fine coat of paint you have. Please tell us more about it.
What is fine blue paint? I'd love to, although it's due for a refresh. Did you know they threatened to paint me red like the...
Oh, dearly me. Seems I was chained to the lever. I wonder how that could have happened.
All right. I'll burn the humble coal.
Thank you. James was feeling glum. It had been a long few months in the steamworks after his accident with another train. The workmen were putting him through his paces. Back? Okay, now forward again. Ugh. Now try out your whistle, James. What was that? Perfect. That was me? You can't change my whistle! This doesn't sound like me at all! Your old whistle was too damaged to repair, James. This is the best that we can do for now. Oh, bother! Botheration! I truly feel for you, James. That new whistle sound makes your paint go all wonky. Nobody asked you, Duncan. At the yard, the other engines tried to help James.
Your whistle sounds just fine, James. I quite like it.
It's not completely out of character.
Yes, you'll get used to it.
I hate it. It's all that hurricane's fault. Without this accident, I would be as splendid as ever. Next, James met Thomas and Stanley at the yard. Hello, James. Wow, you sound so pronounced, James. Nice whistle. It's not funny. I don't like this whistle. It's the worst. Oh, I didn't know it bothered you that much. Well, surprise, Thomas. Whoops. James decided that the only way to solve his problem was not to use his new whistle.
Cheer up, James. You just need a good run.
Will it fix my whistle?
Well, maybe it'll fix your attitude.
James and Emily puffed along the line with their goods train. Ahead was a crossing, and James was supposed to whistle. But he didn't. Beep! You know, a warning would be nice.
James, you're supposed to whistle at crossings.
What does it matter? You whistle enough for the both of us.
But you're the lead, James. It's your job. And you should really let that go. I don't whistle as much as you make it sound.
Pah! I didn't want to be the lead.
You need to get over yourself. I know it's difficult after a crash, but you can still be really useful.
Later, James was collecting his passengers. Aye, James. Good to see you out and about again. Yes, it is. I heard you got a new sound and whistle. Do you like it? So much. Just then, the guard's whistle blew, and James was ready to huff off. But he wasn't paying attention to the luggage cart stuck in front of him. James still wasn't whistling. Hey, look out! James crushed the luggage cart. Luckily, no one was hurt. You should have whistled to us. We might have been able to stop you. Now we must pay the passengers for their goods. James felt worse. Bother passengers! Bother that accident! Bother my whistle!
Whew! It's not our fault!
James, there's no need to take it out on the trucks. You need to take a deep breath, and I want my old whistle back now! James, calm down! James! Stop! I know you're having a tough time with this. Going through a rebuild can be hard. You're not the same. But you need to pull yourself together. We all know you're still a useful engine. With splendid red paint. You're right. Hurricane is gone. There's no point to taking it out on others. Don't let your temper control you.
James went to watch the sunset on the quay. I guess you know what it's like to be different.
Beg pardon?
Sorry, I meant like after an accident and all.
Ah, yes. Better than most.
I wish this never happened.
I get that.
But sometimes embracing the differences is what helps them go away and makes you stronger in the end. So am I. I've heard he's so big he's barely allowed to work on our rails.
Hank will be performing for us before the reception at Knapford. So, Thomas, you will go along to ensure he doesn't get lost.
Oh, yes. He's from a faraway land. What's it called again?
You're right, Percy. He's from the...
Well, would you looky there, a shiny red car, puffy white clouds, and a big blue sky. If I do say so myself, it's a great day to be an American.
Ooh!
Welcome to Sodor, Hank. Thomas will be your tour guide for today. Just follow him for your run.
Alrighty, sir.
Still a little tired from my journey. I don't really feel like pulling anything. I'll just get this little blue engine to do it for me. He seems pretty easy to trigger. I mean, encourage. Hello?
Howdy, Thomas. Now you look like one of the finest little engines I've ever seen.
Little? I'll have you know I'm very strong.
Those freight cars are way too heavy for you. Let me take them for you.
No thanks. I can do it by myself.
I'd be happy to help.
Hank?
Ah, trust me, sir. He insists.
Was new to the island of Sodor. He was bigger than most engines, and quite the sight to behold. One day, he met Thomas at the junction.
Morning, Hank!
Howdy, Thomas. I was supposed to be dropping off that tractor from Farmer McCall's, but looks like it still isn't ready.
Oh dear, well those shop workers best speed it up. There isn't much time to spare before harvest.
For sure.
Oh, Hank, this is Terrence. He's a tractor as well.
Hello.
Howdy.
I need to get to the lumber mill. Would it be alright if I came along on your train?
Of course. I'm headed right along that way to drop off some cargo as well.
Right on.
Terrence was coupled to Hank's train, and they steamed off for the lumber mill.
It's been a while since I've seen a tractor like you.
What do you mean?
I mean with those caterpillar tracks. Ain't much in the area of round wheels, but they sure get a lot of traction.
Why, yes they do. Thomas used to make fun of them until I pulled him out of a snowdrift one winter.
That Thomas is a cheeky little engine.
but determined to the core, if I do say so myself. Soon they arrived at the lumberyard.
Hello, Terrence. I see you've brought a big engine and lots of work to do.
Haha, yes. This is Hank, Trevor. He's given us a famous ride. Alrighty, I've got some other work to do, so I'll drop off the logs here.
Excellent. I'm here to help the millers cut the logs into proper pieces of lumber.
Terrence was happy to be busy.
Finally, some hard work.
Terrence tugged the logs over to the millers, cut the pieces into useful timber using a saw powered by Trevor's flywheel. They were an efficient team. Soon they had a large stack of boards. Hank rolled by. Fine work. I'll be back to pick up the lumber after this drain.
We only have to clean up and load the lumber into the flatbeds. I'll help tow the debris. I'd like a change from sitting beside this saw.
A crane was brought in to help load the lumber onto the train. Finally, Terrence and Trevor had finished. They were watching the crane do its work.
What a good run. Yes, I do like to keep busy all the time.
Then there was trouble. Someone wasn't paying attention. The crane swung around and hit the water tower. Water sloshed everywhere, and the track was blocked.
Well, bust my bell. Looks like we have a little problem.
The crane is damaged. We can't use it to stand the tower back up.
That's fine. We can do it.
Terrence and Trevor were chained to one side of the water tower, and Hank was chained to the other.
One, two, three!
Well done! Now that's what I like to call the American way.
Feels like the hard way to me.
Good work, everyone. Soon, Terrence was back on his flatbed. Hank took him with a train of lumber. After delivering the cargo, Hank took Terrence back to his field.
Today was a good day.
Sure was. No drama, no big lesson at the end. Just a nice hard day at work. Just the way I like it. Me too.
Arthur loves working on his branch line by the fishing village, but when the fishing goes out of season, there isn't much to do. So, Sir Topham Hatt gives Arthur other jobs around the island to keep busy.
Peep peep! Hello, Oliver!
Arthur was working at the copper mine. The ore was loaded into steel wagons, and Arthur would take it to places like the harbor and the docks, to be shipped across the ocean, or to the steelworks to be melted down and cast into metal parts.
at the steelworks again.
What? Did he just say steelworks? It's not steelworks. This is the ironworks, you ninny. Wait, it's not steelworks? We literally have the word ironworks painted on our side, Bert. But nobody calls it that. I thought the painters had made a mistake. Instead, everyone calls it the steelworks, or smelter's yard. Excuse me, scrap yard.
Hey! I have copper ore.
Ore? Or what?
I don't have time for this.
Aye, better puff along nicely. We don't want another incident like when you were delivering coal here, eh?
How about another incident where I biff you off the rails again? Would that suit you better?
Just drop off the ore and be gone.
With pleasure.
Lucky you're one of the fat controller's engines.
I didn't really want to cause trouble, Oliver. I had a spotless record since I got my branch line a year ago. They're the ones who messed it up when I was delivering coal.
Yes, but even without that, you still would have had to break your spotless record to save me.
And I did. But it's not the same saving an engine.
Are you sure you really need to have the spotless record still, Arthur?
Why, of course. It's who I am, Oliver. Arthur the spick and span engine with a spotless record.
But you've already broken it 3 times.
I have a new one, and I'm not going to break it. Not again. Arthur puffed back to the copper mine. He saw an engine when he arrived.
Hello, who are you?
You don't know me.
I've never seen you before.
Oh. Where are my manners? I'm Diesel. Diesel number 2.
They really don't name any of you, do they?
No. It's quite a shame. Anyway, Sir Topham Hatt has sent me here to help deliver the copper. I hear it's rather heavy.
It can be. I suppose I'll get these trucks loaded then.
Perfect.
Diesel watched as Arthur shunted.
Why are you so gentle with the trucks? They're meant to be bumped around.
I have a spotless record. I never have accidents.
Well, almost never.
You seem very proud of your spotless record.
I am.
Soon Arthur had arranged Diesel's train. Remember, these go to Brandom Docks. Do you know how to get there?
I'm sure we'll be fine. Thank you, Arthur. You're a fabulous shunter.
Arthur felt flattered. Why can't all Diesels be like him, instead of nasty and mean? Diesel pulled into Brandom Docks.
This should be easy enough.
He dropped off the copper, except for one truck. And back to the mainland.
Hey you! You forgot one truck!
That Diesel's taking one of our copper trucks! Stop him!
What?
It must be a mistake. Arthur caught up to Diesel.
Diesel! Diesel number 2!
Diesel scowled.
You still have a copper truck!
I know, it's mine now.
Why would you even... You can't just take it!
Where will you go? Copper's quite valuable. We Diesels need it for our wiring.
Rubbish! That isn't how this works!
Oh, please. Just go back to having your spotless record, engine.
Arthur was cross. He tricked me. I must stop him from stealing our copper.
No. I don't want to break my record again.
But Diesel wasn't going to stop. Is a spotless record really that important? What about when someone's in danger? Or this?
Suddenly, Arthur knew what he had to do.
Diesel, stop now or I'll make you stop.
You won't.
But Arthur did.
Thank you. mess was being cleared.
Diesel, how did you get back here? I did not request an engine from the mainland, and most certainly not you.
Why would you steal copper anyway? Engines have no use for it. But Diesel didn't answer.
Well done, Arthur. That was a tough call.
Later, Arthur went to visit Duck's branch line.
You did the right thing, Arthur. Sometimes, I suppose, it isn't always spotless to be really useful.
Yes, and that's all right.
It's nigh impossible to be perfect. Just look at old Dougie here.
Eh, speak for yourself. You're the one who smashed into the side of a signal box.
I'll always be an extra careful engine, but a spotless record isn't something I need to have in order to stay useful.
Wonderful. Now we can teach you the Great Western way of doing things.
Duck, please.
I'm just kidding.
The diesel engine had come to help on Edward's branch line. His job was to help with the goods work. He pulled long trains up and down the line and brought trucks for Bill and Ben. One day, Boak was on his way past the Vicarage Orchard.
What's that noise?
It's the bees. They're all in these boxy things called beehives. I'm taking them to the station this afternoon. The vicar says his bees make good honey, and he's giving some of them to his friends.
Take care, you two. Don't make the bees angry. They might sting you. Goodbye, Trevor.
Oh, nice to see you.
Later, Bill and Ben were sorting trucks, but they scampered off when they saw Boko.
I remember the first time I met those two. They nearly made my eyes pop out. Edward soon put a stop to their games.
Edward is the only one who can keep Bill and Ben in order. I sometimes call them the Bees.
A good name. They're terrors when they start buzzing around.
Just then, James bustled in.
What's that, Duck? Are you afraid of bees? They're only insects, after all, so don't let that buzzbox Diesel tell you different.
His name is Boko, and he didn't.
I wouldn't care if hundreds are swarming around. I'd just blow smoke and make them buzz off.
Buzz, buzz, buzz.
James huffed away.
Sorry for him.
No worry. I've met James before. He seems a little self-absorbed.
Well, that, and he doesn't take a liking to Diesels. I understand him in that regard, but not all Diesels are rude. They should be given a fair chance.
James, where are you going? Come back! Oh, my nose! It hurts so much!
I guess we'll have to find another engine.
Boko's driver returned from the signal house.
James has been stung by a bee and can't take his train.
What?
An interesting situation for sure. Anyway, we've been asked to take the passengers.
What a pleasant surprise. I've wanted to pull coaches for a while.
They went to the station and gathered the passengers.
All aboard!
The guard's whistle blew and Boko set off.
They had an excellent journey. Lots of passengers told Boko what a great railway it was.
Job well done. Let's take these coaches back to the yard.
James was trying everything to get rid of the bees.
Oh, I'm dizzy. Why isn't it working?
We could try washing them off.
Anything, please!
Oh, there's James. James puffed quickly past and had no idea Boko was doing his work for him.
Out of the way, you diesel!
Par for the course. The yardmaster arrived. We have a goods train that needs to reach the docks. James is occupied. Can you take it there? Boko knew it would be best to help.
No problem.
As Boko collected his train, Duck arrived.
Are you taking James's train?
Yes. He's still trying to get rid of the bees.
You're a better engine than I. I'd be teasing him, let alone doing his work for him.
It needs to be done. We need to make sure the railway runs on time. Boko set off again. James saw that Boko had taken his train, but he was too concerned with the bees.
Finally, Boko had delivered the train.
Thank you for helping, Boko. I think this is the first time we've had to deal with an engine getting stung by a bee.
I understand. Must keep the line reliable.
The next day, Boko was in the yard when James arrived.
How is your nose?
Dreadful. But I came to thank you for taking my trains yesterday.
All in a day's work.
And I'm sorry for being rude to you before. You are a useful engine. And since that day, James and Boko have become firm friends.
Especially the ones who had been chosen to be in it. All except Toby. He was feeling anxious.
I don't know why I feel this way, Henrietta. I know I should be excited, but I just feel like I'm not gonna fit in.
You're a square engine trying to fit in a round shed, Toby. This is nothing new to us.
It's not that. The Fat Controller has chosen 2 tank engines and 4 tender engines to be in the parade. But there's only 1 tram engine. That's me. It's just like I'm being tacked on the end. Don't really belong there.
Of course you do, Toby. You only happen to be one of the unique engines on the railway. That doesn't make you less important or make you not belong.
Well, it just doesn't feel that way to me.
Thomas and Percy were shunting around the great water tank, helping to get everything ready for the parade.
There you go. Now stay there.
You can't make me. I'll find another way to break my brakes, and we'll go rolling off again. We trucks won't stop till the revolution is a success.
Okay.
These trucks are very spirited. It's like they have some sort of cause nowadays.
The only cause they have is trouble.
Thomas, Percy, I'd like you to meet Flora. She's a new steam tram. Well, new to us. She's going to be joining us for the engine parade.
Hello!
Welcome, Flora!
Percy, a moment. Alright, Flora, let me show you to your shed. Another steam tram?
I know! Isn't it exciting? Now Toby won't be the only tram engine anymore.
Exactly.
I know that look, Thomas.
How do we tell Toby?
What do you mean, Thomas? It's not a bad thing. Just because an engine's new to the railway doesn't mean you can't like her.
Percy, not now. Toby's been the only tram engine for years. I don't think he'll like having someone else steal the attention. A lot of his passengers are train spotters.
Toby does other work too, Thomas. You act like he's a relic that belongs in a museum.
I'm just concerned, that's all. Percy and Thomas were still discussing Toby and the new tram engine that evening. Let's just wait to tell him, all right?
Fine, but we can't hide it forever.
Hello, Toby. How was your day?
Oh, it was just dandy, Thomas. I did ask Mavis if she'd like to join the engine parade, but she's too busy.
Really? Why?
Toby didn't think it was wise to say exactly why he had asked.
Just to get her out of the quarry. It'd be a nice change of scenery for her.
And be more inclusive.
Oh, well that's fine, Toby. You'll be the shining star of the parade, being the only tram engine on Sodor.
Yes. Yes, I will.
The next day was the day of the engine parade. Thomas and Percy still had some work to do.
I can't believe you lied to Toby last night.
It wasn't a lie. He is the only tram engine, as far as he knows.
The parade is today. How are you going to keep them from meeting? And why? Sir Topham Hatt will be cross if Laura gets lost.
Don't be silly. We're just going to have her help us get things cleaned up here.
Good morning, you two.
Hello, Flora. Ready to be really useful?
Yes, I am.
Very good. Take these empty trucks to the quarry to be loaded. Then you'll have to pick up flatbeds from the timber yard. Take the train to Knapford Yard. We'll meet you there for the parade.
I can take those, Flora, if you like to shun here instead.
Thanks, Percy, but I'm rather looking forward to a nice run. Bye.
See you later, Flora.
That'll keep her busy for a while.
I can't do this, Thomas. We must tell Toby. If you won't, then I will.
Percy, you must go to the docks to pick up a special delivery immediately.
Yes, sir.
Looks like you'll be occupied, Percy.
And Thomas puffed away. Toby was getting out of his shed to start the day.
I don't want to go to this parade.
Don't be silly, Toby. There's nothing to be afraid of. You've done way scarier things than this.
It isn't scary to lead a parade. I just don't like feeling like a spectacle. Everyone likes to say how special I am because I'm a tram engine. But the truth is, I'd really rather just be a normal engine like everyone else.
You are a normal engine, but you're also unique, Toby. It's something to be proud of.
It's hard to believe when I'm the only one like me on the entire island.
Toby went to collect Henrietta. Finally, Thomas had finished shunting at Great Waterton. The engines were starting to gather for the parade, but Toby was nowhere to be seen.
Where's Toby? I feel like I should go find him.
Thomas puffed to Toby's shed, but he wasn't there.
Cinders and ashes! Where is he gone? Maybe he's at the coachyard fetching Henrietta.
Thomas puffed into the yard, but he couldn't see Toby anywhere.
Botheration! Where would Toby go? He wouldn't just disappear.
Toby, this is not very characteristic of you.
I know.
I know it's tiring, always hearing that you're an antique and special. All we want is to be really useful like everyone else. But hiding here is just running from your responsibility. The Fat Controller has given you a job. You should do it.
You're right. I just wish I wasn't alone.
You aren't.
Let's get to Great Waterton.
Toby! There you are! I was looking for you.
What are you doing in the shed here?
I was...
You were hiding from the parade, weren't you? I knew he didn't want to be the only tram engine. That's why he asked Mavis.
Oh, come on, Percy. Let Toby speak for himself. Obviously, he's proud to be the only steam tram.
Thomas, I've got all the trucks collected.
Already? Who's that?
I'm Flora. You must be Toby. I'm glad to find there's another tram engine on this railway.
Me too. Are you coming to the engine parade?
Yes, we are the tram engine pair.
Hooray!
You're happy? I was worried about being the only tram, Thomas. But I see now that I don't have to be, even if I were the only one. But now Flora is here too, so it's just extra good.
Oh dear, I've run out of coal.
I'll shunt you to the hopper, Flora. It's my fault you ran out.
Oh, and this is your own special coach. You can take him when you get back.
Flora filled up on coal and collected her coat. Then she and Toby left for the parade. I was wrong, Percy.
It happens, Thomas. Now let's go. We're in the parade too.
The festival parade was ready to begin.
I'm so glad I'm not the only tram engine.
We're unique, but if we're really useful, then we're all the same too. Off we go!
It was summertime on the island of Sodor. Tourists were coming to the island, and the engines were busy with extra passenger trains. The coastal line is a popular route for tourists. It connects several lines, some of which haven't been used in a very long time. Molly had been given a train of trucks to take. She was going to help Harvey clean up scrap.
Good morning, Molly. Pulling empty trucks again, I see.
Only for a little bit. I'm helping clean up the coastal route before the tourists arrive.
And I'm picking up the Fat Controller. He's on holiday, and we're going exploring in the forest. Not that anyone asked. Sounds like I have the most important job, as usual.
No need for that, Gordon. It's just a passenger train. Anyone could pull it. What if someone else has to replace you one day?
Huh. I'll never get replaced. I'm the fastest and the best.
Gordon steamed off. Fastest and best, forever and ever.
Have fun on your adventure, Toby. I'd love to go exploring.
Adventure is everywhere, Molly. It'll find you if you aren't careful.
Molly steamed along the coastal route. It was a beautiful line with lots of countryside.
Oh, look, the coastline. I could get used to this.
They came to an old section of track. Molly slowed down because she felt one of the rails buckle.
Ooh, this track really needs maintenance.
The signal was set at clear, but the points were switched to a different line. But Molly didn't know the difference.
This doesn't look like it's been used in a long... Ow!
Thick branches barred Molly's path.
Oh, make it stop. Phew, a clearing. Driver, where are we?
Looks like an old yard.
How mysterious.
The driver looked for a phone to call for help, but there weren't any. I guess we'll go back to the signal box.
Doesn't look like anyone's been here in years.
Something feels different about this place.
They backed up the line to the signal. Molly, what were you doing down there?
We got lost, but there's an old yard in there. It looks very special. We're supposed to be helping Harvey collect scrap.
Me too. I'm glad I found you. I can show you the way. Arthur buffered up and they set off together. Later, Harvey had loaded the trucks of scrap.
What kind of yard was it?
I'm not sure. It looked pretty normal. There was a shed and a grassy platform and a set of buffers. But it felt different.
I'd like to go see it for myself. If nothing else, maybe the Fat Controller will have it cleared for the new ballast mines down here.
I can take these trucks myself, if you two would like to go see it again.
Thank you, Harvey. That sounds like a good idea.
Adventure awaits! It's just a yard, but... Molly and Arthur set off for the siding of the woods. Wow, it's beautiful in here. I wonder how long it's been abandoned.
What is this place?
Molly, look what I found. Is it time for another coal run?
Past my buffers. I've never seen trucks like that.
Don't worry, we'll get you cleaned up in no time.
I think we should tell the Fat Controller about this yard.
This isn't some yard. It's called the Grotto. Where's Lady? Lady? Like Lady Hat?
Our engine!
I don't know who that is.
Let's get back to the main line. We're going to need help. The next day, Sir Topham Hatt went with Molly and Arthur to see the grotto. Harvey and Trevor also came to help clear the branches and bushes. The grotto, you say?
That's what the truck said. Who knows how long they've been here?
Indeed. Arthur, you are right. This would make a good yard space for the mines. We shall have it cleaned and repaired immediately. But sir, what about the engine? We've never heard of an engine called Lady. Lady?
Sir, there's an engine living at that old mine we found yesterday, past the castle. I thought he was a ghost. People say he's called the Old Warrior. I suppose this is the end of my holiday. I'll have to call Lady Hat and postpone for a few days.
How's that for adventure, Toby?
All I meant was a little trip on an old line. This seems to be causing quite a stir.
It's exciting.
Let's get clearing then. I want to see this engine. Is it finished? I want to see him. We had to cut a deal with the scrap diesels for the copper, but we got what we needed. Well done. Time and tide and railway. Wait for no man.